Local councils want the new government's help to generate more revenue so roads and pipes can be better funded. This as Christchurch City Council, heavily in debt, says if nothing's done, rates there could face a sharp rise. Ryan Boswell reports.
Still rebuilding 12 years on from the Christchurch earthquakes, and the City Council is crippled in debt.
I want to get out there how much financial strife we're in.
It owes $2 billion. Repayments would be $15 million a month. So as part of the city's 10-year plan, councillors are considering what to do.
There are major challenges. I mean, one of the biggest ones at the moment, if you look in the US, is that long-term interest rates are holding up, are actually increasing. And, you know, that has a flow-on effect here, as people will see in their own homes.
Homeowners warn that if nothing is done, then rates will rise by 18%.
That would definitely be pretty troublesome.
It's a bit of a scary number, to be honest.
It'd probably just mean we'd have to cut back in other areas, like maybe feeding the kids.
In an attempt to stay afloat, pools could be closed, libraries shut, and maintenance on roads and pipes delayed.
If people want to pay 18% rates, great, keep going the way we are. But not my, not I couldn't, well, I couldn't afford 18% rates on. But it's not fair. 18% is no good.
How much more would you be paying?
God knows. God knows. No, I don't know.
The council has land that's surplus to requirement, and strategic reviews are underway on assets like the port.
We have lots of levers at our disposal to bring that down to a more palatable level. What's also really not palatable to people is closing libraries and shutting swimming pools.
But most councils are struggling to fund what's considered basic but vital infrastructure.
We've got rates as our tool. Some councils have investments, but other than that, there's not the same levers that we can pull to be able to fund this level of investment that's going to be required.
Christchurch now braced, with the council promising it will consult before any rates rises are locked in.
All right, Ryan's with us live now. This isn't just a Christchurch issue, is it, Ryan? Local government New Zealand's been wanting action on financing for some time now.
That's right, Simon. It's now being suggested that local councils are given the power to introduce local taxes. So, for example, road user charges or bed charges for the likes of tourists to help generate more money in these communities. Local Government New Zealand has been working on a plan. In fact, it was talking to National and ACT prior to the election, and it hopes to have that detailed information in front of the new minister before November.